So the ocean is a really complex and dynamic environment, and ideally we want to study organisms in their natural setting. So we built this system to take microscopic images underwater. My name's Andrew Mullen. I'm a PhD student at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography at the University of California, San Diego. My work focuses on designing instruments that operate in the ocean, specifically building systems to take microscopic pictures in the underwater environment. With the instrument, we were able to look at individual coral polyps and see their behavior and competition with other types of corals. So I dive with the system to the subject I want to image, and then I set the imaging unit up on a tripod and I control it with the underwater computer. When we set it up, we first put it into rough placement using the tripod, and then using the tunable lens inside, we're able to precisely focus on what we want to look at. So we've deployed the instrument mostly to look at coral reefs, and we've looked at coral polyp interactions with other corals, coral feeding of plankton, as well as coral bleaching and algal growth over coral. So one of the really interesting pieces of technology that we use in the instrument is this electrically tunable lens. And it's a soft lens and it focuses the way your eye focuses, so it changes its shape. And that allows us to accurately focus on the subject we want to image. So while coral reefs are very large in size and can span kilometers, the individual organisms that actually build those reefs are coral polyps, which are only a millimeter approximately in size. So corals compete for space on the reef. If they grow close to each other, they'll fight basically for that space. And so we introduced corals nearby each other, and then we used the instrument to look at those interactions. And you can see one of the polyps starts emitting its mesenterial filaments, which is basically its gut, and so it's digesting the other coral next to it. People have studied this at large scales in the field and potentially small scales in the lab, but no one has been able to look at these small scales in the field before.